Hey up, you bunch of southern shandy drinking twats. My name's Watson, Paul Joseph Bastard Watson. I'm a Yorkshireman. I say what I like and I like what I bloody well say. Unfortunately, sometimes I tend to say things that completely and utterly contradict something that I've said previously and expose me to be a massive hypocrite and an idiot. So today, my good friend, Brother Neuro, is going to show you some of my biggest and most shameless displays of two-faced stupidity. Take it away, Brother Neuro. You bastard.
Thanks, Paul. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Brother Neuro from whatacuntyouare.com, and these are seven times that Paul Joseph Watson ended up having an argument with himself. Number one, boycotts. Paul Joseph Watson loves the free market. At least he does when it serves his own political agenda. In 2017, there was a call for companies to pull their adverts from the website Breitbart, which was highly successful, resulting in 2,200 advertisers pulling out. Paul Joseph Watson responded to this on Twitter by saying, "God forbid we should actually have to challenge their ideas. Let's just use this witch hunt tactics to financially sabotage them." So as you can clearly see, Paul Joseph Watson is staunchly against boycotts, and he much prefers the approach of challenging and debating the issues. Except, of course, when it comes to, say, Planet Fitness, when they announced they would allow members to use whichever changing rooms they felt corresponded to their gender. Or CPAC, who he once called everyone to boycott after referring to them as a bunch of stuffy cunts. Or Angelsoft, who he once called for a boycott of after they released a misandrist Father's Day advert honouring single mothers. Oh, and he's also called for boycotts of people and organisations like Azealia Banks, Grubhub, The Wall Street Journal, The Daily Show, Virgin, Celebrity Cruise, Patreon, BBC, Vice, NBC, Channel 4, The Eagle Forum, The Toronto Symphony and Zoopla. But apart from these few dozen exemptions, Paul Joseph Watson is totally against boycotts. Number two, paedophiles. In 2017, when A-list celebrity and Hollywood actor Kevin Spacey was found to have inappropriately touched a 14-year-old boy whilst drunk at a party, Paul Joseph Watson dealt with this very sensitive issue in the most rational and sensible way that he could. Firstly, by taking a quote from a Slate article that said people shouldn't call Spacey a paedophile and claiming that this one quote was an example of the left being obsessed with protecting paedophiles. However, he decided that this gross and unfair generalisation simply wasn't going far enough, which was why shortly afterwards he uploaded a video entitled "Paedophiles Rule the World," in which he said, and I quote, "So now Pizzagate's been debunked, that must mean that anyone who talks about the connections between paedophilia and people in positions of power must be extremist crazy conspiracy theorist, right? Wrong?" is a huge part of the establishment's war on Trump, centred on their fear that the net is closing in on their sordid illegal activities. So as you can see, Paul Joseph Watson really does take the issue of child abuse by people in positions of power very seriously. At least he did, until literally a couple of months later in the same year, after nine women came forward accusing Republican politician and former Chief Justice of the Supreme Court in Alabama, Roy Moore, of varying degrees of sexual misconduct, including three accusations of sexual assault, one of which against a 14-year-old. It was at this point that Paul Joseph Watson suddenly had a completely different perspective regarding retrospective accusations of sexual assault against public figures in positions of power. As he said in this tweet, "We've entered the territory where mere accusation alone is enough to sink someone's political career, whether it's true or not. Dangerous. I'll be making a video about this." And he did make a video about this, which was called "The New Sexual Puritans," in which he said, "Third wave feminists and social justice warriors are trying to impose a new and onerous form of sexual puritanism. The preeminence of innocent until proven guilty is being jettisoned. Now mere accusation alone is enough to ruin someone's career. Do you understand how dangerous that is?" So to summarise, Paul Joseph Watson takes the issue of child abuse by men in positions of power very seriously, unless you accuse a politician or celebrity that he likes or supports, in which case the accuser is obviously a lying two-faced bastard trying to destroy an innocent man's career. Paul Joseph Watson is even willing to ignore the fact that someone may have publicly defended or condoned the act of child abuse by men in positions of power, as long as that person happens to be, Milo Yiannopoulos, who is also a member of the same political party as he is. Number 3. Government regulations. As I said earlier, Paul Joseph Watson loves the free market. He loves capitalism and he hates government regulations. This is why he's against so-called net neutrality, as he clearly said in 2015, stating, "Government regulation of the internet is about control, not neutrality." And later on that same year, "Net neutrality is a Trojan horse for government regulation of the web." Then, in 2017, YouTube suddenly started demonetizing his videos, which he thought was totally unfair and an example of discrimination against him and his people. When he pointed this out, people tried to remind him that YouTube is a private company, to which he replied on Twitter, "Blah blah blah, fuck off. Basically, Google is the internet at this point. Public commons regulations. Specific new laws need to be drafted to stop internet monopolies like Google strangling free speech." So, as you can see, government regulations are bad, except when they're not. Okay? Number 4. Private business owners' rights. As well as being a big believer in a deregulated free market, except of course when he's not, he's also a big believer in the sanctity of the rights of private business owners to be free to run their businesses however they want. Now obviously, this is obviously just a code word for if you don't want to serve any blacks or queers in your establishment, then you don't have to. And this is why Paul Joseph Watson supported the Supreme Court's decision not to charge a Colorado baker for refusing to make a wedding cake for a gay couple because it violated his religious beliefs. But then something weird happened. All of a sudden, certain websites on the internet started suspending or outright banning white heterosexual males just like him, many of whom he really liked. At this point, he decided to stand up and speak out for his fallen brethren, like when Twitter unfairly suspended Steven Crowder for a whole week. Twitter has suspended known alt-right extremist Steven Crowder. He is locked out for over a week over a parody video. This is beyond a joke now. Censorship of conservatives must be addressed by lawmakers. Hashtag free Crowder. So, Paul Joseph Watson fully supports the right of a private business owner to be free to discriminate against whomever they wish, as long as they only target ethnic minorities and gays. Number 5. Jokes. Like most Yorkshiremen, Paul Joseph Watson is known for having a very crude and politically incorrect sense of humour. He's also a free speech absolutist who believes there should be no limits on what anyone can or cannot say. This is why he was a huge supporter of Scottish YouTuber Count Dankula, who was arrested and fined £800 in a court of law for making a, as he said, satirical video in which he taught his dog to do a Nazi salute every time he said, "Gas the Jews." This video, according to Paul Joseph Watson, was quite clearly a joke, and anyone who was offended by it and even took it remotely seriously was a moronic, butthurt SJW liberal snowflake. You know, just like that time that some guy on Twitter made a joke about Antifa super soldiers meeting on November the 4th to behead white people, and Paul Joseph Watson actually thought it was real and even wrote an article about it on Infowars.com, and when he realised it wasn't actually serious, he altered the article to simply condemn this so-called joke for going too far and not being okay. So, it's okay to make jokes no matter how offensive they are, unless of course they offend Paul Joseph Watson, in which case it's not okay. Number 6. Depression. As Paul Joseph Watson said in his Truth About Depression video in January 2017, "Depression is nothing more than dissatisfaction with life. It's temporary unhappiness. It's your fault you're depressed because of your own poor life choices." but a year later he decided to start a bizarre crusade against soy, in which he claimed soy was the reason behind modern men being such feminized beta male left-wing pussies. And he also said that soy lowers testosterone, and low testosterone causes depression. So just to recap, depression is a myth created by crybaby millennials who are just unhappy with their own life choices. And it's an epidemic caused by men consuming too much soy, which is making their balls shrink. And please don't even bother asking him about the fact that his brain force supplement contains soy, because la 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 la, he can't hear you. And number 7, whether or not a shooter's politics actually matter. In October 2018, a man named Cesar Sayak was arrested for mailing pipe bombs to 14 prominent enemies of Donald Trump, including Hillary Clinton, Barack Obama, and George Soros, peace be upon him. When it became undeniably clear that Sayak was a Trump supporter, I mean, look at the cunt's van for fuck's sake, Trump apologists resorted to the "you can't blame Trump for the actions of some of his supporters." But Paul Joseph Watson decided to go a bit further and tried to paint himself as the voice of reason and balance on this issue by claiming, "just like James T. Hodgkinson, the anti-Trump Bernie fan who tried to massacre Republican congressmen, apparent Trump fan Cesar Sayak is clearly mentally ill. Bernie wasn't to blame for Hodgkinson's actions, and Trump isn't to blame for Sayak's actions." Now, reading that tweet and taking it at face value would probably lead you to believe that, whether you agree or disagree with Watson's point, he is at least being consistent and treating both sides fairly and to the same standards. However, this tweet is actually describing the exact opposite of what Paul Joseph Watson really said about Hodgkinson back in 2017. "Shooter James T. Hodgkinson is a Bernie Sanders supporting leftist," Paul Joseph Watson tweeted with a screenshot of Hodgkinson's Facebook, which had Bernie Sanders' photo as the cover image. He even wrote an entire article, which he posted on the InfoWars website, which is still up, in which he says, "the shooter also signed a petition calling for an investigation into Trump-Russia ties, confirming he was radicalized by the mainstream media and his obsession with conspiracy theories about Russia interfering with the election." He then added, "the shooter was a fan of John Oliver, Rachel Maddow, and The Daily Show." And he concluded with, "a terrorist attack targeting conservatives by a deranged anti-Trump Russian collusion obsessed leftist. It's going to be hard for the mainstream media to spin that. This is a game changer. When will the mainstream media stop radicalizing domestic terrorists with their hysterical anti-Trump Trump narrative? It has to stop now before more innocent people are targeted." So it's ridiculous and unfair to suggest that a domestic terrorist has a political agenda and to hold the politicians accountable for possibly saying things that enable slash inspire their actions, except for when they're proven to be a left-wing supporter of Bernie Sanders, in which case it's everyone on the left's fault, including the Daily Show's. And that's my list, ladies and gentlemen. Did I miss any out? If so, please post them in the comments below. Don't forget to like this video, share it around, subscribe for more, and please consider supporting me, Brother Neuro, on Patreon today. That's it. Thank you. Good night. May God be less.